Hello, Gupshuppers. Welcome to another episode of Football Gupshup. If you can please subscribe to this channel, press the like button, give your comments, and please share this episode with your friends and family. So friends, let's start today's episode with a huge news. As you know, the transfer window is approaching near. You know that as many days remaining, the clubs start to do their activities with their unfinished businesses. So let's start today's episode with the huge news, which has to do with Manchester United. As you know, Manchester United wanted Jadon Sancho. So far they haven't been able to, but recently they have made a bid of 100 million euros, which has been flatly rejected by Dortmund. As you know, that United have only made one signing, and they have been an increasing pressure on the board to spend more money. So far United have been able to do so. So what they did was, yesterday they put in a bid for 100 million euros, and which was rejected by Dortmund. And the news coming in now is that United have started to looking for the alternatives. There were many names mentioned, but one of the big name which has been mentioned is of Ousmane Dembele of Barcelona. What the news have been circulating in the media is that Ousmane Dembele is being wanted by Manchester United. Manchester United want to get Dembele on loan, and then they would like to pay the fee for next year, which comes about to almost 50 to 75 million euros. So it looks like that Dembele might play for Manchester United if United are not able to get Sancho. So far, most of the news coming in from Germany is that they wouldn't want to do any business with United. But so far, United have been talking to Dortmund, and still there is a chance, very little chance, that United might be able to price Jadon Sancho away. But if it doesn't take place, then Dembele would be the one who would be the alternative name for which United might move on. So moving on to the next news, which is to do with Edinson Cavani. United are interested in Edinson Cavani. He has been a free agent, and United might sign him as a striker so that they could play Martial and Rashford on the wings. We know that Edinson Cavani played for 7 years in PSG. He was a very good scorer for them, same as Zlatan. So we could see Cavani playing for Manchester United. As for another name which has been linked to United is of Jovic, who plays for Real Madrid. The reports are coming in that United might take him on loan from Real Madrid, which would be a very very different kind of transfer. But these are the reports which have been circulating in media, and we could see a striker joining United. So let's see if we will see United getting Dembele and Edinson Cavani, because they are being pressured by the fans to spend money which they haven't done so. Another name which has been linked is Ismail Sarr. He is one of those backup names which has been linked, that if any of the major names don't come around, so United might move in for him late in the transfer deadline. So moving on to our next news, it has to do with the outgoings of Manchester United. So far there are so many players who on United list would like to be moved upon. One of the new names in that list is Daniel James, who have been said that he might join Leeds United, and Ismail Sarr might be brought in for replacement, as well as Telles is one of the names which have been recently linked, and the news is that he is pretty much close to joining United, and we could see him as United's new left back. So let's see if he will be playing for United at the end of the deadline. Now we'll move on to our next topic, which is to do with the outgoings. As reported earlier, that Daniel James is the new name which has been linked to leaving United. It is to do with Leeds United. As you know, Leeds United were interested in Daniel James before he moved to United. We could see him joining Leeds. The reason is due to because he hasn't been able to produce that kind of early form which he did when he moved to United. So we might see Daniel James leaving, and we could see another name coming in. As for Chris Smalling, he is pretty much close to joining Roma again, but on permanent deal. The reports are coming in that it might be around 15 million euros, so we might see Smalling playing for Roma this season. As for Andres Pereira, it has been said that Lazio have almost accepted the deal with United. It will be a loan deal plus permanent purchase. And going on with Rojo and Romero, they might also leave, but so far no names have come in as which clubs would want to take them. As for Diego Dalot, he is being interested by two Italian clubs, AC Milan, and recently news have come around that Roma might be interested as well. So we might see Dello playing in Italian Football League, where he would be as a first choice right back. So far, the transfer news has to do with Manchester United due to the reason that they haven't spent that much in the transfer window, and the pressure is increasing on them via their fans that they want the club to spend some money. So folks, we'll be moving on for the next news, which has to do with the other clubs. It has to do with Leeds United. The news are coming in that Leeds United are interested in wingers. They are speaking to Bayern Munich with regards to one of their players, whose name is Mikael Cousins. Permanently, the deal is around 20 million plus euros. So we might see him playing for Leeds United, as Leeds United are looking in for some wingers such as Daniel James and Mikael. So Leeds United are also shopping pretty good in the transfer window. Moving on to the next target, which has to do with Leicester City. They have done a deal with Saint Etienne. It has to do with one of the players called Fofana, who plays as a right back, and the deal is valued about 40 million euros. We will see Fofana playing for Leicester City, playing for Brendan Rodgers' side, which will be a pretty exciting thing to see. As for West Ham, they are speaking to Napoli for Nicola, who apparently it has been reported that might be a replacement for Declan Rice, who has been reported to move to Chelsea for 40 million euros. So we could see West Ham moving for Nicola, so that they would have a proper replacement if Declan Rice leaves for Chelsea. So friends, this is all we have for today's episode. Please like this episode, please share this episode, please comment on this episode, and as well as please subscribe to this channel. Your support is pretty much needed. Hopefully you've liked the episode. We'll be back with more news in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching Football Gupshup. See you in the next episode.